You know, people always ask me the same question. They say, hey Jack, what is MMP? And can you please explain the intricacies of our system of government? More specifically, how the final makeup of Parliament corresponds to my vote on election day? Yes, I can.
Mixed member proportional MMP. It's the system that we use in our democracy. But how does it work? Why is it so complicated? Buckle up, New Zealand, let's get educated. When you go to the polls on election day, there are two different decisions that you gotta make. You've gotta vote for your electorate and one for a party. But what does that mean? Well, I'm just getting started. Your electorate vote is for someone to represent the area that you live in. And the party vote determines the final proportion of seats that each party is given. So in our parliament, MPs can represent a whole range of different parties and communities. Big or small, they can all have a voice because of the choice we get with MMP. You've got two ticks, MMP, proportional democracy. It's harder for a single party to achieve majority. Two ticks, hip hooray, MMP will save the day. Even minor parties can participate and have a say. Three ticks, minus one, MMP is so much fun. Incentivizes compromise, promotes cooperation. Two ticks, it's so easy, you got two ticks. And that's MMP. There are 120 seats in our parliament, so you gotta control 61 to form a government. Electorate seats are allocated to begin with. A plurality of votes is all that's needed to win with. The seat goes to the person who was voted the most, so each electorate seat is first past the post. 72 seats are decided like so, and the party vote determines where the last 48 go. Each party seats are topped up until they're proportional. Match the party vote nationwide. So the final allocation represents the percentage of the vote achieved by every side. But to get party seats, 5% must be beat. That's the threshold to meet. Or win an electorate seat. Then you can bring other list MPs in, even though the threshold wasn't reached. Simple. You've got two ticks. Have your say, grab your ballot, tick away. With MMP, get twice the voting action on election day. Two ticks. Yeah, alright, MMP is out of sight. Tick those little boxes, exercise your democratic right. One tick, then one more. Voting shouldn't be a chore. It's how you remind those politicians who they're working for. Two ticks. It's so easy, you got two ticks. And that's MMP.
You need 61 seats to be in government, but there are ways to supplement if you don't have enough of them. If no single party holds a majority, then agreements can be made to take collective authority. Coalition is when parties can agree on conditions in which they make joint decisions and share the cabinet positions. Or they can form agreements based on confidence and supply. It's a less formal means of getting parties on the same side. And that's why each box you tick could really matter a lot. Cause even minor parties might have influence at the top. So it's vital that you vote and that your two ticks are in it. It's not a house of representatives if you're not represented.
Two ticks, spread the word. It's simple, so don't be deterred. Election day is coming, it's our chance to make our voices heard. Two ticks, shout it out, MMP without a doubt. Proportional representation is what we are all about. Two ticks, one then two, you know what you gotta do. Make a choice and use your voice, democracy depends on you. Two ticks, it's so easy, you got two ticks. And that's MMP.
The other question I always get asked is, historically, why has youth turnout at general elections been disproportionately low? And I can only assume it's because, up until now, there hasn't been a catchy, upbeat pop song to explain how our democracy works. So now there's no excuse. Go vote.